हेलो एंड वेलकम टू रेडियो सिटी इंडिया. मेरा नाम है हैंसन और स्टूडियो में मौजूद है मिस्टर प्रेडिक्टर आशुतोष. वेलकम टू द शो.
हे हैंसन, हेलो व्यूअर्स, ऑलवेज अ प्लेजर टू बी हियर.
और जैसा आप जानते हैं ये चल रहा है क्रिकेट का ब्लॉकबस्टर को पावर्ड बाय विमल एलआईसी. और एक हफ्ता हो चुका है, मतलब सेकेंड वीक बीत चुका है, तो बहुत सारे मैचेस हुए, बहुत सारी इंटरेस्टिंग बातें हुई. तो आज भी हम वही करेंगे जो पिछले हफ्ते किया था. दो वीडियोस बनाएंगे. फर्स्ट विल बी अबाउट द बॉटम फोर, द सेकेंड विल बी अबाउट द टॉप फोर. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग अबाउट द बॉटम फोर, वन प्लेयर हु हैज बीन लाइक तूफान मचा दिया यहाँ पे आके,
एंड्रे रसेल.
क्या खा के आता है? आपको उनका डाइट के बारे में कुछ पता है?
ये भी अपने स्पॉन्सर का विमल खा के आता रहे.
जो भी हो, जुबा तो केसरी हुई नहीं. चलो तो
they have played 5 games, mm-hmm. won 4 games, mm-hmm. and I think he's been the man of the match in 3 of those games.
So abhi chalo, abhi unke bare mein to second video mein baat hogi, ki wo table topper hai filhal. So let's start with the team at the 8th position. Koi surprises nahi hai iske liye. Ek bhi match nahi jeeti hai 6 mein. That is the Bangalore team.
I don't know, I mean they have been hampered. The Australians are back. I mean they got Stoinis in, but Nathan Coulter hasn't yet joined the squad, so he'll be joining on the 13th. I think by that time the tournament might as well be over for them. So they'll tell Nathan Coulter no need to come. We'll save on the money for the auctions next year.
Yeah, and Washington Sundar,
I'm surprised how there are many people coming in, going out. I'm still surprised how Washington Sundar doesn't get a game.
Yeah,
and Siraj continues to get a game after game.
Like I told you outside, Akshay Kumar's movie Gold, जहाँ पे सनी कौशल को एक ट्रम्प कार्ड से रखा जाता है, फाइनल में लेके आते हैं. So Washington Sundar को भी शायद इसके लिए रखा था. But right now the final looks very very like in a distant dream.
I'll be very surprised if they make the playoffs.
Even if they win all the 8 matches, given like हो गया कुछ चमत्कार, 8 मैच जीत गए.
Typically, you need to win 8 for a direct qualification, or if it can boil down to run rate if you win 7. So, either way, it looks virtually impossible.
Yeah.
I think
run rate wise, they are like
Virat Kohli should concentrate on the World Cup.
Their run rate is also minus 1.
No, but if they win the remaining 7 out of 8, their run rate will also improve. No,
but given the thing that their run rate right now is very bad,
there you can virtually write them off.
Yeah. So let's talk about the two games that they lost like ekdam end mein aake. That is the team, one with Mumbai, which was already discussed, and one was with the Kolkata team.
I was surprised their spinners had done well, and Andrew Russell, although he's a blaster, between spinners and fast bowling, he is a bit susceptible against spin. Chahal had bowled well, Pawan Negi had bowled well. First and foremost, they didn't play Washington Sundar. Secondly, they got the pacer in when Russell was playing. So they could have gone with Negi to Russell.
Yeah.
So, I'm not saying this in hindsight. It's easy to say in hindsight. But if you look at his record, Andrew Russell is a bit susceptible against spin as compared to pace.
So now we have the schedule with us for the next week. Do you see any improvement?
How many games are they playing this week?
They are playing at least 2 games for sure. One is with the Punjab team. That is very late in the next week. No, they are having only one match.
And that is against Punjab.
Yeah, that is Saturday.
At Chandigarh, a belter of a track.
Yeah.
Maybe Kohli and ABD, if they perform well, and it's 13th. So I believe Nathan Coulter will join that squad as well. So one more hope for the RCB fans, but I doubt. I mean, they might win this game, but I don't see them really going far.
Okay. ABD and Kohli, they played well in one of the matches, but they lost due to the Russell storm that was there. Let's talk about the second last team, that is the Royals.
Royals, as I had expected when we spoke about Royals in our preview, I had expected them to win initially, because initially they had the strong squad, and they were supposed to lose players after 25th of April, with majority of their Englishmen joining the squad, the World Cup squad for the national team. But incidentally, they haven't won even in the initial part. And their only victory is against the Bangalore team. So, yeah. I don't foresee them going too far in the tournament. And it has become a 6-horse race now.
Yeah.
For the 4 positions in the playoff, with Bangalore and Rajasthan. out of reckoning.
Okay. So, you don't see them like coming back strongly in the
Not really. I mean, they might win one or two odd, but I don't see them qualifying and making it to the top four.
Okay. Now, let's talk about one person in that team. Paid a lot of money last year. This year also, he made a decent amount. Jaydev Munadkat. Dropped for Varun Aaron. And Varun Aaron was also dropped after 1 hour.
Varun Aaron should have been given a longer run. Jaydev Munadkat and Manish Pandey have been the biggest disappointments of IPL. Last year, they were bought at a very high purse. Everything one was 10.5 crores and one was around 12 crores, 11.8 crores. This Manish Pandey was retained at 10.5, while Jaydev Varun was rebought at around 7 to 8 crores. So, considering the amount spent on both of these, they have been the biggest underperformers of the Indian League.
So, they have around two matches.
Another major disappointment has been Ben Stokes.
Yeah.
He hasn't really justified his top billing.
Even Jofra Archer to an extent.
The stuff has been there a bit, but Ben Stokes hasn't been because when he played for, I believe, in the first inaugural season, I think he was with Pune then.
Yeah.
RPS.
Yes.
Okay. So that time he had a fantastic season, but two seasons with Rajasthan haven't been great.
Yeah. So they have two matches for sure. One is with the Chennai team. The second is with the resurgent Mumbai team. अचानक से मैच जीतने लग गए भाई लोग सो
आई डोंट आई विल बी सरप्राइज्ड इवन इफ दे विन वन आउट ऑफ दिस
सो बोथ द टीम
अनदर थिंग इज दे आर मिसिंग संजू सैमसन संजू सैमसन हैड अ फैंटास्टिक इनिंग्स एंड देन ही वाज इंजर्ड फॉर द लास्ट टू गेम्स होप ही इज बैक एंड देन मे बी दे कुड इफ दे चेज दे कैन विन दे कांट विन बैटिंग फर्स्ट बिकॉज देयर बॉलिंग इज वेरी ऑर्डिनरी
सो वरुण एरन लॉन्गर
इवन द गेम वे दे वन अगेंस्ट बैंगलोर दे वन इट वाइल चेजिंग
So, Varun Aaron, longer run for the week, at least two games more.
Yeah, I think he should be getting
because it. Because Mithun also flopped yesterday, because he's quite new.
The only silver lining has been
Shreyas Gopal,
absolutely. And to an extent, Steve Smith has come back in form. And I like the Josh Butler as well.
Yeah.
Josh Butler has been doing well.
Yes. So, now let's move on to the team at number 7. That is the Punjab team.
Number 6, I believe.
Number 6. Punjab team.
Punjab. I somehow don't like them as a squad individually. But individual players, they don't have any big names. But somehow, other than Chris Gayle and KL Rahul, I believe. But somehow, as a team, they tend to gel well and they have done well. As compared to, say, Bangalore or Rajasthan. I mean, if you consider the squads, you'll see man-to-man Rajasthan and Bangalore would be stronger than Punjab. Yeah. But somehow Punjab has done better than
that.
So, it's a six-horse race and I believe Punjab is very much there in the race. I like their coach Mike Hessen. I've spoken about him a lot.
Yeah.
I believe he's the binding force which gets the best out of these low-profile individuals.
Yeah. So, even Ravi Chandran Ashwin's captaincy
has been smart. Sarfaraz has been a revelation.
Yeah.
Mandeep Singh has been a good finisher. So, that is where the role of the an astute captain and a smart coach comes in. Getting the best out of individuals and knowing what role they are accustomed for.
And if you look at the team, it's like ex-Bangalore team.
Not really ex-Bangalore.
Gail, Rahul and they have even Sarfaraz is there. Even Mandeep Singh who played last year. So, almost like
Mandeep Singh, they got him on board because the name is Punjab and they didn't have a single Punjabi on board. I mean, they had planned to release Yuvraj Singh, who was the only Punjabi in the last year's edition. So, they got Mandeep Singh especially on board to go in with the local flavor.
Yeah.
They need a local guy as a part of the 11.
Okay. So, any changes in this week? Any team changes?
How many games they are playing this week?
They are playing one, that is today. Against the Hyderabad team. They have one with Mumbai Indians. They have one on the weekend, for sure.
So they are playing three games.
Yeah, three games.
So, I see them breaking
into... And one is with the Bangalore team.
I see them breaking into the top four.
Into the top four?
Yeah. Because they are playing three games. Yeah. So, I believe they can win two and make it to the top four. But winning one, I believe they will surely win against... Bangalore.
Yeah.
They need to win out one out of the other two.
Okay.
And so, Sam Curran has been a revelation.
Yeah.
I was just coming to that.
I still, between the two brothers, I prefer Tom Curran as a bowling all-rounder.
Yeah.
Sam Curran has done well initially. Let's see how he goes.
Yeah. So now let's move on to the team at the fifth position. The last in this video for sure is the Delhi team.
Delhi
young gun, young blood,
all mostly Indians.
Yeah.
And Rabada, dead by Rabada.
Yes. So what do you have to say? Like, they have been decent. They are losing one match, winning one match. So
when we spoke about the team previews, I expected them to make it to the top four.
Mm.
They have just hung in there.
Mm.
So they are in the top six. Mm. They are in the reckoning. Let's see how they go about it. So biggest plus point has been the Indians.
Yeah.
Prithvi Shaw, Shikhar Dhawan, Shreyas Iyer, Rishabh Pant, someone or the other has always stepped up.
Mm.
And the two foreigners who've really done well are Chris Morris and obviously Kagiso Rabada. Kagiso Rabada now holds the purple cap as well.
Yeah,
So, I still remember last week also we spoke about it. Jaise unhone Andrew Russell ko bowl kiya tha, super over mein. Waisa bowling mujhe recently yaad nahi.
We've discussed that Rabada and Bumrah are among the best two bowlers across the three formats.
Mm. So, now we come to the Indian players. Even Prithvi Shaw has come back to form per se. Even the others. So even Iyer is back in form.
True.
So where do you see Shikhar Dhawan here now?
I always say that
you are your favorite player.
It's not about favorite. It's about horses for courses. He is an Indian. He's an Indian international. He's a top order batsman. He was the highest scorer in T20 internationals in 2018. So do you think any doubt about his position?
No, but given the
and as I told you also previously that Hanuma Vihari doesn't fit into the team, and two games he lost, he couldn't finish, so he's missed out, and Akshar Patel is coming.
So the bowling has been changed a lot. What do you have to say? Like Avish Khan only one game.
Harshal Patel in some games. Then Ishan Sharma played initially, came back in. Amit Mishra played a couple and went out. So they've rotated, but as long as they are able to get the combination right, it's fine.
Okay, so they are playing two matches this week.
They have so many coaches as well. So everybody would be picking and choosing their favourites.
They have Saurav Ganguly, they have Ricky Ponting. Like two legends.
Praveen Amre is part of the Mohammad Kaif. They are part of their talent scouting.
So, a lot of things happening in the Delhi team.
How many games
are they having? Two games. One is against the Kolkata team. The second is against Hyderabad.
I think I like Hyderabad a lot. So, I doubt Delhi can beat Hyderabad. If they manage to curtail the Russell storm, they might as well get the better of Kolkata.
Okay. So, they have already done that once.
And they are the only team to beat them, in fact, as of now.
Yeah, actually. And because it went to the Super Over, so that's why maybe. So, this is the video, guys. So, we'll be back with the part 2, where we'll be discussing the top 4 teams. So, tab tak ke liye dekhte rahiye Radio City India. This is me, Anson, and Ashutosh, signing off. Bye-bye.
Yo.